We all know the schools are indoctrinating our kids. The transgender agenda is in our schools, and it's coming for our kids. I'm not just going to speak about school today, but also about entertainment, about social media. Our kids are being assaulted from every single corner of the culture. And I trained as a public school teacher. I was licensed as a secondary English teacher. I've always been a proponent of the public schools. I sent my kids to a Title I school. I felt like you send your kids to school where you live. You neighbor with your neighbors. 2 years ago, I pulled all my kids, and I'm homeschooling them now. I tell everyone I know that public school is no longer a safe place for children in this country, and I'm not sure private school is either in many cases. It's really a horrific situation that we're in. These are some quotes, and Mary mentioned one. Parental rights end when children are enrolled in public school. That was a fifth grade teacher that was quoted in Abigail Schreier's book. The head of the education program in Los Angeles said to teachers, talk about transgender, talk about gender diversity, get it into every moment of the student's day. The last quote is from a blogger who's quoted in the Huffington Post. This was back in 2015. I would be happy, delighted, overjoyed to cause children to disagree with their families on the subject of LGBTQ people. They are coming. They're not coming. They came for our kids. They came for them. And they want to completely sever kids' relationships with their parents, because parents are the kids' best protection. The artist, by the way, that I've used a couple of images for slides, is the same artist that did the images for Aaron Brewer's book, Always Aaron. So that's where these have come from. This is a gender critical artist. Our kids need help. Our kids are getting it from every single quarter. They need help. All kids should have the same messages from all sections of society. They should be getting the same message from their parents, from their teachers, from their pastors, from their friends' parents. And it used to be that way. You sent your kids out into the culture and they heard pretty much the same thing you believed at home. Not only has it come the opposite way, but they are getting the same message from just about everybody, and it's that they could be born in the wrong body. And parents, we're the last ones saying, no, that's not true. And in many cases, unfortunately, even the churches are not backing us up on that. I think we've seen the gender unicorn, the gender-bred person. You see this on the walls in schools. You see this in the counselor's office. This is taught. This, by the way, these were created by transgender college students. These were not created by any sort of scientific person, any research. This is some transgender college students who threw this together and said, yeah, this is humanity. This is how people are. The NEA, the National Education Association, largest teachers union in America, they are whole hog for this. This was their book of the month back in June. One of the middle schools in my district last year put out their summer reading list. 7 out of 30, almost 20%, 25% of the books on the list were sex and gender messaging. Other books you'll find in the classroom. These are in the libraries. Beyond Magenta has pornography in it. I mean, it's just gay porn. I'm reading a book right now by David Levithan called, I've forgotten the name of it now. It's hideous. It completely separates body from soul. It makes parents and teachers just like the teachers in the old Peanuts cartoons, wah, 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 wah. They're two-dimensional flat characters that have nothing to do with the children's lives at all. And this is the message our kids are getting. This was in my district. That is a transgender activist. And Lily Eskelsons Garcia, who is the president of the NEA, came to Ashland Elementary School in my district and read the I Am Jazz storybook to two classes of kindergartners with effectively no warning to parents. They sent a letter home on a Friday afternoon, long, disingenuous letter with the word transgender in there once in the middle. If you have kids, you know you're not reading everything that came home in the backpack on a Friday afternoon. So they slipped this in. Kids were crying. Kids went home to their parents terrified to go to the doctor because the doctor might tell them, I made a mistake when I thought you were a boy. You're actually a girl. Boys going home terrified their penises are going to fall off and they might actually be a girl. This was horrific. This is a horrific thing to do to children. This is GLSEN's model school district policy. This is what's being forced into every school district in the nation. Virginia has adopted this. The activists in Virginia have asked the Virginia Department of Education to tell them which school districts do not accept and adopt this so that they can go and apply pressure there. Here's a couple of gems from it. School staff shall not disclose anything about a student's transgender status, even to parents or guardians. It is critical. Parent-guardian approval is never a prerequisite. They don't tell. They don't tell parents. I threw this in. This is, goes along with what Father Sullen said. The GLSEN model school district policy has three citations. That's interesting what Susan said about three. I hadn't realized that. They have three citations, two of which originated with GLSEN. This is just like Big Tobacco saying, we're going to do a study to find out if nicotine's bad for you. Oh, it's not bad for you. They lied. They're lying. And two of these are self-selected surveys. This is what they're using as the research support for these policies.